gentlemen. Welcome everyone to Tuesday Night Smackdown. We are here in Anchorage, Alaska. Well, Shinsuke Nakamura coming out here to the ring.
Yeah, this should be good.
Shinsuke Nakamura will be in our main event tonight against Daniel Bryan. We'll see what he has to say. When I come out here, I bask in the energy that flows through the thousands of people that surround me. However, there's something amiss tonight. Something eating away at every single superstar backstage. Fear. I wonder why that is.
The fans are eating it up.
I'm starting to realize something. This isn't what I signed up for. I'm here to face the best, beat the best, and become the WWE World Heavyweight Champion. If doing this, coming out here and talking trash is what I have to do to get what I want, then fine, I'll play ball. Shane McMahon doesn't seem to think I'm deserving of a shot at the WWE Championship because I won't play by his rules. Well, if playing by his rules is what it takes to get ahead, then I guess I'm not getting ahead. I'll never play by anyone's rules. I don't want there to be any questions about who I am or where I stand. You want to know something? You don't have to ask. I'm going to tell you, whether you like it or not. Thank you, NZ Universe. With your support, I can't lose. You've never given up on me, and I'll never give up on you. Together, we are unbeatable. Together, we can conquer anything in our path. We are a united, unstoppable force. Oh, I do all of this for you.
That just about sums it up there. Short and sweet.
Well, I think Shinsuke Nakamura making it clear he's wanting to go for that WWE World Heavyweight Championship. First match of the night, we have a number one contendership Cruiserweight Championship match against Inferno and Kalisto.
The following contest is scheduled for making his way to the ring from the other side of darkness, weighing in at 135 pounds, the Fireman N.R.O.
Here we go, and you can follow this and other matches on social media at hashtag WWE2K.
The fans have been demanding this one-on-one contest, and here it is.
Inferno has had a couple of matches here already and made a huge debut, I believe, pinning Lince Dorado, the Cruiserweight champion. Here comes Kalisto.
And his opponent from Mexico City, Mexico, weighing in at 170 pounds, Carlito.
With all the buildup over the last few weeks, this match is guaranteed to not disappoint.
You know, Cole, this could go down in the record books as an instant classic.
The WWE Universe on its feet, looking forward to this great match.
Kalisto has had a couple of matches here in my universe mode.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Michael Cole alongside Jerry the King Lawler here at Ringside King. Tonight should be extremely exciting.
Well, you said it, Cole. It looks like we don't have to wait long for the action to start either. Let's go. This one's going to be great.
Just writhing in agony.
Now Inferno. In control here. Now Kalisto in control.
Acrobatic action at its absolute best.
Calling Inferno to his feet. Now Kalisto with a huge springboard
tricks.
Hurricane Rana.
And a wicked elbow shot right there. A bit off his game here, but he's very aware of who he's in there with and what he has to do to rebound.
But it's important to know that this match has been so evenly contested so far, you really can't pick a winner.
And on top of that, John, these two guys couldn't be any more evenly matched at this point.
Unleashing it for the second time now. Whoa! He now knows getting your feet taken out from under you is a fast way to hit the canvas. Keep your eye on this one.
Yeah, this should be good.
Now Inferno going up top.
Oh,
a nice cross body
here this
there.
Evening.
And that was awesome. And he reversed it. Good move there.
Able to reverse it. Dragon Inferno center of the sort of center of the ring.
Covers. This one's far from over.
Only one count.
A lot of power left in this superstar.
And he dodges that one. This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
Kalisto gets out of that one. Nice move, Kalisto.
Nice move there.
Uh-oh. Big move coming.
Now Kalisto.
And here's Kalisto.
That's a nice move there.
This may very well be it.
Only a two count there.
He's going for it all.
This
now Kalisto going up top.
What makes a man even want to take
for
a gamble like that, Ken?
Splash.
How should I know? I'm scared of heights.
You can practically feel the wear and tear that's been done throughout this match. Kalisto showing signs of slowing down. At this point, it's all about how he responds and potentially rebounds.
Call me old-fashioned, but a good finisher actually finishes a match. How many times is this guy going to go to his?
Yeah, but despite that, he still appears to be in the driver's seat.
He's not exactly hopping up to his feet here.
Well, what do you expect, Michael? Did you see what just happened?
What a match!
I think everyone knows how that must feel. Oh man!
Now Inferno.
I wouldn't know what that was.
Barely connecting with that.
As
Inferno going for the pin here.
Look at this.
He's only a two count.
We got a lot of match left.
Two.
Kalisto taking on some offense now.
He'll need to find a way to turn things around here.
Never say never, but things are not looking very good for him right now.
Guys, I've lost count of how many finishers this guy's gone for.
Eventually, it might be time to try
some. Now, Inferno for a pin kind of attempt. That gets the win.
Set out to do, and that was win.
Here's your winner, the Fireman NRO.
Looked near flawless down the stretch. Big win.
Man, if that's the type of action we're going
to
get all night,
Inferno, I can't wait to see the rest of the card unfold. Believe it or not, that's just the beginning, folks. As Moose goes up against Randy Savage in a number one contendership match for the Intercontinental Championship. Welcome back.
As
Moose now making his way to the ring.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Atlanta, Georgia. Weighing in at 294 pounds, Goose.
Oh boy, we're in for a treat tonight. Both of these superstars look geared up and ready to go.
And we have another great matchup scheduled for you here tonight.
Moose has been in a feud of some sort against Randy Savage. I believe last week it turned physical as these two beat each other down in the ring after, I believe, Moose called out Randy Savage. Savage now in the ring as he definitely seems like, I don't know, he seems like the bad guy here.
Everybody, and thank you for being part of what promises to be an amazing night. I'm Michael Cole, joined as always by the King himself. He's a Hall of Famer, Jerry the King Lawler.
Well, enough about me, Michael. Let's talk about you. What do you think of me? We're starting off strong, Michael, and things are just going to keep getting better.
Moose immediately just beating down Randy Savage. Now Randy Savage able to reverse it.
Showing us something new from his repertoire.
That's cool. I like new stuff.
He's starting to stumble here.
I fully expect him to bounce back, though. This is the type of one-on-one atmosphere where he thrives.
I'm not concerned. I don't think I've ever seen him look more motivated than he looked heading into this match.
Well said, John, and now's the time for one of these guys to take hold of this match.
Now, here's a huge double-handed choke slam, it looks like. Now Moose, I think he's going for that clothesline, but Randy Savage able to reverse it.
When this guy's on, look out.
Wait a minute, Cole. Is he going?
Now Randy Savage with a pile driver.
And now it is show off time. Don't waste time gloating here.
Expanding the repertoire with that move.
Man, he's still down after that move. I almost wonder if his bell got seriously rung there.
Can you just look at this man? He's all business.
And that's the way he has to be if he wants to win here tonight.
Now Moose in for a pin, but only a two count.
Too early in the match for that to work.
I don't know what else Randy Macho Man Savage can withstand at this point. I'm not sure how much more he has to give.
Well, this might finally be where one of these guys starts to pull away.
I don't know. There doesn't seem to be a clear-cut winner yet in this one.
Same after that
back breaker there by Randy Savage. Yes, now he goes up top rope.
We'll get the opportunity to witness another classic sack job, courtesy of the Macho Man.
Heads up! Or what's he going to do to follow that up?
Looks like he's starting to falter. He'll need to find a way to turn things around here.
Hey, it's the WWE.
Now Randy Savage in for a cover.
And the shoulder's up now.
Only a two count.
Nice. After the amount of punishment he suffered, it's simply amazing that he's still in this one. I'd say that's more embarrassing than anything else.
Nice reversal. Is this it?
Some damage has been dished out, but certainly not enough to see this one's even
elbow drop by Moose.
How much damage did that do? A lot from the looks
now,
of
it. Now, Moose looking for that clothesline of his, I believe.
We know what this is.
As he now drags Randy Savage in the middle of the ring and in for a cover and a win.
Here is your winner.
Man, what a contest. We definitely just witnessed one for the ages.
I'll remember that one for a long time.
It's going to be tough for Randy Savage to rebound from this one. Believe it or not, that's just the beginning, folks.
Well, up next,
stay
we have a women's Divas number one contendership match for the Divas Championship. Charlotte versus Brandi Rhodes. Both of those two have actually pinned the Divas Champion, Lita. So we'll find out who gets to face Lita at Backlash. Here we go, our third match of the night, as Charlotte making her way to the ring.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring from the Queen City, Charlotte.
You can feel the intensity level inside the arena rising. Clearly, this SmackDown crowd can't wait for this one to get started.
Charlotte, not having very many matches here in my universe mode, but if she's able to win this number one contendership match, then I think it'll definitely propel her career to greatness, I guess. Well, and here comes Brandi Rhodes.
And her opponent from Detroit, Michigan, Brandi Rhodes.
Oh, I can't wait to see this one with matches like this. It's no wonder SmackDown is watched by so many people. Thank you to the WWE Universe for making this show
Brandi
such
Rhodes,
a success.
Having very few matches here as well, but able to pin the Divas champion Lita.
Thank you for joining us tonight, folks. We have an amazing night ahead of us.
Yeah, and we're just moments away from tonight's opening match. I can't wait. This is a perfect way to get things going.
Look at her here. She's just reveling the opportunity to make a mockery of her opponent.
Oh, I love it when she gets this kind of attitude.
Well, if that's any indication, she's not taking any prisoners in this one.
No, she's on a mission here.
What do you believe Charlotte is thinking about?
She's undoubtedly one of the most egotistical competitors we've seen in the women's division in quite some time.
She's certainly a force, Michael. But you have to remember who she's in the ring there with. Neither of these girls are pushovers, that's for sure.
I don't know what you mean, Michael. It's not a crime
definitely
to love yourself.
Back and forth match so far.
You know, if you take direct hits like that, it becomes hard to move. If you can't move, you can't win. Great offense by Charlotte. I'm not sure what made her think now was a good time for a pin attempt.
Yeah, no way that's going to happen this early in the match.
And she pulls a new trick from her bag with that one. She's starting to stagger a bit. Here's what we're going to see what she's made of.
You know, Brandi Rhodes looks like going for her finisher already.
There's no way to predict what's going to happen.
She's complaining with sheep flex.
Neither one of these women has really taken control of this match.
You don't see that move every day.
Slamming the head of Charlotte on the mat of the ring. In for a cover now.
And the shoulders up
in time.
Well, as long as
one
it's up before that three count, that's all that matters.
Ooh, with the point of the elbow. This is not where she wants to be. She doesn't want to let this get out of control, guys.
But, Michael, she's as tough as they come. She should be able to weather this storm.
With an ego like this, you better be able to back it up.
Belly,
we'll find out
belly to belly suplex.
Oh no! Massive damage done there.
She's absorbing some offense here. To be expected, though, given the competition she's in there with tonight.
But I'd say she's still in a very favorable position here in this match.
Now, hold on a minute. I mean, given the number of times that she's used her finisher thus far, it's a miracle this match is even
Charlotte
still going
with
on.
With a huge takedown. And
oh,
now going in for that.
I think she's going for it here.
Figure eight block.
Trying to get her turn. It does.
Getting some more leverage here, increasing the pain on Brandi Rhodes.
Now it's time to fight out or tap out, King.
Actually, is it a figure four leg lock? Definitely looks like it.
Her way out.
No, maybe not.
Oh, action like this has
in any
become
case, Brandi Rhodes able to break her way out of it.
She's just showing off.
delivered a DDT to Charlotte.
Charlotte sees it coming. She is so smart. Oh, reversal. Oh.
What a wild attempt at striking your opponent. I don't know if she could have been further off the mark.
Oh, what a counter.
I think she's trying to prove a point here. Avoids the impact there.
This may settle the score right here.
He's starting to belly suplex.
Charlotte reverses it. There doesn't seem to be any slowing.
Charlotte
down
just
now.
Tossing Brandi Rhodes around in the ring.
She's having a real hard time getting back to her feet. That was a heavy
There's
shot.
A little takedown.
I'm not sure if she knows what planet she's on after that.
Brandi Rhodes able to reverse it.
Look at those eyes. Oh yeah, this could be big.
I think we know what this is.
Now Brandi Rhodes aiming for a cover.
Hey, here's the cover for the win. Two. Well, she might just be running
Charlotte
on instincts.
Still
at this
able
point.
To kick
she's
out.
She's got a tremendous amount of resilience, so I think she's got something left here.
Now Charlotte in for a cover.
This could be it. Count, ref, count. No way. What a
only
kick out.
A two count.
Oh, you're not going to beat her that easily. This match has taken so much out of her. And down goes Charlotte. Oh, no, Charlotte, are you okay?
Dishing out some serious punishment here.
Head.
How you make an impact.
Whoa,
now Brandi Rhodes in for a cover.
Two.
And the shoulders up. It's only two.
Only a two
My
count.
God, what's it going to take?
I don't know. I can't believe this, Michael.
It looks like there's some more fight left to this diva. Look at the look in her eyes. She's in the zone now.
Belly to belly suplex.
We're seeing two outstanding athletes looking to prove their dominance in there. But only one can walk out victorious. Who will it be?
Stay down! Stay down!
It's now Brandi Rhodes. I think she's going for that pump handle suplex again.
There may be no end to this brutal attack.
And this has got to be it.
It's it. It's over. Two.
Brandi Rhodes is the number one contender.
A win.
Here's your winner, Brandi Rhodes.
An emotional victory here tonight. Man, oh man, what a battle.
What a match and what a win. Congratulations.
Hey, this isn't just about going out there and making sure everybody's entertained. You've got
to
win your matches.
Next
and that's
match.
Exactly what happened here. A will to win was on display.
As we close the book on this match, I need to remind everybody just how big of a win this was. Simply amazing.
As Christina Von Erich goes up against a returning superstar and Mickie James. And here we go, one of our last matches before the main event, as Christina Von Erich making her way to the ring.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and from Los Angeles, California, Christina Von Eaton.
Just moments from now, we will get this singles action underway.
Been
can't beat a great singles
making
match.
Quite
They've been
talking
about this one ever since this match was announced.
And on SmackDown, winning quite a few matches so far. one. Here comes Mickie James making her return.
And from parts unknown, the hardcore icon, Mickie James.
This one's going to be electric.
These two have been waiting for this one for quite some time, and to be honest, so have I.
Mickie James making a huge return. As the last time we saw her was all the way back at the Royal Rumble in the Women's Battle Royal.
Hello, everybody, and thank you for being part of what promises to be an amazing night. I'm Michael Cole, joined as always by the King himself. He's a Hall of Famer, Jerry the King Lawler.
Well, enough about me, Michael. Let's talk about you. What do you think of me? This one should be amazing, Michael.
Mickie James immediately on the top rope.
And a wicked clothesline. Back into the ring now.
Wow, I didn't know she had that move in her repertoire. And again, this beautiful diva decides to use that one.
Things starting to go the other way for her.
Back. She's going to need to find a way to mount an offense here.
Look at her moggle. There is absolutely no quit in those eyes.
I don't know. This doesn't appear to be anything she can't work her way out of.
Now a submission hold here.
Wait a minute! If she escapes the
hold. Mickie James able to break her way out of it.
There's not a lot of cushion for your face. As you can see, everything hurts.
No kidding. That's hurting me. Hey! She's clearly not getting paid.
That was relatively easy to get at him. Her back is in some real pain now.
Now Mickie James, I think, looking for a finisher here.
And now looking to put her away.
A huge DDT. Dragging Christina Bonieri into the center of the ring.
Down. Is it enough?
This may be it. She jumped
with the only a two count.
She clearly liked the results from the first time she delivered that move. By the breaker there.
You need eyes in the back of your head when you're fighting this guy.
She's not playing any games tonight. And with this kind of attack, you have to wonder just how much longer they can compete in this match.
Yeah, I completely agree. The way things are going in there, I'd say not much longer. My gosh, this is a beating.
And now Christina Bonieri in control.
That did a lot more than rattle someone's cage.
Yeah, I think that rattled his brain.
That move did it. Now this has gone way past the point of insult. It's gone right to humiliation.
That's right. That was humiliating.
Now both women on the outside. Right into the steel stack.
There's not a diva on the roster that can come back from this.
I don't know how much more punishment she can take.
I don't know. It may sound crazy, but I think she has plenty more fight left in her.
You said it.
Now Christina Bonieri sending Mickie James right into her steel steps.
Both of these competitors have so much resolve, it's going to take a minor miracle to keep one of them down.
Eight. Nine. Nice. Let's do this inside.
Oh, I hate to see it end like this.
Christina Bonieri, I think, barely got in there, but... Unfortunately,
here's your winner,
it was right as the referee. It was right as the referee said 10.
I didn't expect that.
Didn't expect it. Didn't want to see
Mickey James a huge win.
Pinfall or submission. You know, I have a feeling
so
we're going to be
next
talking about
our main event
as
Daniel Bryan going up against Shinsuke Nakamura.
When I say that was an amazing contest.
Here we go, our main event as Daniel Bryan making his way to the ring.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring. From Aberdeen, Washington, weighing in at 210 pounds, the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, Daniel Bryan.
This crowd is on their feet in anticipation for singles action.
With matches like this, it's no wonder SmackDown is watched by so many people. Thank you to the WWE Universe for making this show such a success.
Here comes Shinsuke Nakamura.
And his opponent from Kyoto, Japan, weighing in at 230 pounds, Shinsuke Nakamura.
This one's going to be electric.
I believe the last time we saw Shinsuke Nakamura was all the way back at the Elimination Chamber. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong.
Welcome, everybody, and thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Michael Cole, and to my left, the Hall of Famer.
Daniel Bryan immediately with an airplane spin,
Michael,
it looks like.
Well,
the story ending is
coming of the entire year. We're starting things off strong
Shinsuke
tonight.
Shinsuke Nakamura earlier tonight came out there and said he's coming for that WWE World Heavyweight Championship. Making it clear that
let's take a moment to
he
discuss
wants that championship.
In a business where backstabbing isn't all that uncommon, it's refreshing to see a superstar as respectful as him.
Well, we're going to find out who's the better competitor, that's for sure. No gimmicks here, just some good old-fashioned one-on-one action.
Well, good for him, Michael. There's plenty about the sports entertainment industry that should be respected, including me, the king.
Well, I've never seen him do that before. The first time tonight we've seen that move. Work is being put in by Daniel Bryan.
Daniel Bryan completely controlling this match. It's now Shinsuke Nakamura able to reverse it.
That's a classic textbook maneuver.
Exactly the way it should be done.
You know, we used to say Daniel Bryan was one of the most humble superstars the WWE has ever seen. But as his stock has risen, he's become an altogether different kind of competitor. This is a man who now feels there is no one he can't get the better of in the ring. The Flying Goat wrestles with a huge chip on his shoulder.
Daniel Bryan stalling a bit here. With these two guys, we all knew this was going to be an all-out battle.
I tell you, we knew this was going to be a close affair, but I don't think we expected it to be this time. What a match.
He's delivering it.
And now, there's his vicious kicks to the chest of Shinsuke Nakamura.
What questions people may have about Daniel Bryan, nobody has ever doubted his toughness or his guts.
Dragon Shinsuke to the center of the ring and for a cover now.
Daniel Bryan makes the cover. Look at this action.
And only a two count.
Oh yeah, let's go. Oh, he's in trouble now.
Now Daniel Bryan in for the yes lock. Will Shinsuke tap out right here?
Hey! And he fights out of it. He breaks the hold.
Shinsuke able to get out of that.
Man, these guys are throwing bombs. They're pulling out all the stops.
A few superstars are as dominant as this guy. Nakamura seems to have gained the upper hand for the moment.
He's having a seriously hard time getting back to his feet after that.
Now Daniel Bryan with another airplane spin.
I have never, in all my years in this business, seen a crowd react to a figure like they do Daniel Bryan. This might be it.
And for a cover now, but only a two count.
He simply refuses to stay down.
Here's a level of destruction no one was expecting.
I certainly didn't expect to see this kind of damage.
Measuring Daniel Bryan.
We might be seeing the beginning of the end.
For that Kenny Shaza.
Mindset be at this point.
I believe that was. And for a cover here. And just barely. Only a two count as Daniel Bryan is still in this.
I've seen every episode of SmackDown over the years, and I assure you this one ranks right up there with the best. He's certainly showing us something new from his repertoire.
That's cool. I like new stuff.
Now Daniel Bryan with a springboard
move.
I don't like the look in his eye here, folks.
I don't like his entire face.
Now Daniel Bryan going up top rope.
This guy's just getting warped. Hey, from the top rope.
Huge crossbody splash on Shinsuke, but it looks like it missed a little. I'm not sure.
Each of these competitors is looking for the slightest hint of weakness
now,
in the other.
Daniel Bryan, I think he's looking for that. Yes, lock.
If you ever see a weakness in your a tight hold here, does he have enough left to fight?
Will Shinsuke be forced to tap? And he taps.
And Daniel Bryan has done it.
Here's your winner, Daniel Bryan.
Big win here to start the show.
Man, when you get a one-on-one match like that, you hate to see one of them come up short. But that's just the harsh reality.
Oh, a huge win for Daniel Bryan.
This job so much.
As they still don't have a contender for Daniel Bryan. So perhaps next week we will find out. But that's it for Tuesday Night SmackDown. and I will see you this Thursday for Impact Wrestling.